In this particular video, I want to talk about the Claisen-Schmidt reaction. You can see on the screen the set of reactants as far as this Claisen-Schmidt reaction is concerned. You will see that the first reactant molecule is an aromatic aldehyde which lacks the alpha hydrogen atoms. If you look here onto this carbonyl group, this is the alpha position here, and it is not having any alpha hydrogen atom. Moreover, even in the second reaction here, the same aromatic aldehyde has been used, which do not contain the alpha hydrogen atoms, right? So this means, as far as the Claisen-Schmidt reaction is concerned, out of the two reactant molecules, it is mandatory that one of the reactant molecule must be devoid of alpha hydrogen atoms. This means that out of the two reactant molecules, one reactant molecule should be selected in such a way that it does not contain any alpha hydrogens. Now, if you look on the second reactant molecule, in this first reaction here, it contains an aliphatic aldehyde, and this do contains three alpha hydrogen atoms. And as far as this second reaction is concerned here, which is using an aliphatic ketone molecule, once again, it also contains three alpha hydrogen atoms, which you can see right here, right? So this means in the Claisen-Schmidt reaction, out of two reactant molecules, one should be having alpha hydrogen atoms and the second one should not be having the alpha hydrogen atoms, right? Moreover, if you look on the conditions here, you will notice that the conditions are actually basic in nature, right? And if I want to show you the product molecules here, you will see that in the first case, the main product molecule is an alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde, right? Why we are calling it as an alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde molecule? Because starting from this carbonyl group here, you will see that this is the alpha position, and this one here is what? This is the beta position. And in between the alpha and the beta position, there is present a double bond, or let us say unsaturation, right? So in the first reaction, means starting from some aromatic aldehyde and adding an aliphatic aldehyde in that, under basic conditions, we will get what? We will get a molecule of alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde. And in the second reaction, which starts from a molecule of aromatic aldehyde to which some aliphatic ketone molecule has been added, using the same basic conditions, the final product molecule will be what? It will be some alpha beta unsaturated ketone molecule, right? So these two are, we can say that, very good examples of the Claisen-Schmidt reaction. And you will notice one thing here, that this reaction, this first reaction, is in between some aldehyde and an aldehyde molecule. But the two aldehydes are totally different here, right? On the other hand, the second reaction is actually a reaction in between some aldehyde and a molecule of ketone, right? So this means that the Claisen-Schmidt reaction is nothing. It is actually a special case of cross-aldol condensation reaction under the basic type of reaction conditions. Once again, I repeat, the Claisen-Schmidt reaction is nothing, but it is actually a special case of cross-aldol type of reaction under the acidic type of, under the basic type of reaction conditions, right? So let us move forward. Now, if we talk about the very first reaction in detail, we will see that the first reaction will be in between this aromatic aldehyde and this aliphatic aldehyde molecule. And this will be a cross-aldol type of reaction, and it will be giving a beta hydroxy aldehyde molecule of this type, right? So I will not be discussing about the mechanism of the cross-aldol type of reaction, because I have already explained the mechanism in my previous video lectures. You can check it out from there, right? So first of all, when we will be adding this aromatic aldehyde to this aliphatic aldehyde molecule under basic conditions, it will be undergoing a cross-aldol type of reaction, resulting in the formation of this kind of beta hydroxy aldehyde. You will see here that in this beta hydroxy aldehyde this part is actually coming from the aromatic aldehyde, I mean this molecule here. On the other hand, the second part, I mean this part, is actually being derived from this aliphatic aldehyde molecule, which is acetaldehyde in this case. You will see that because of this cross-aldol type of reaction, it will be resulting in the generation of a new bond in between this carbon atom, in between this carbon atom and this carbon atom here, which you can see, I mean this new bond is being formed here, right? Now once this beta hydroxy aldehyde has been generated, what will happen next is, there is also a possibility that the aliphatic aldehyde molecule, which contains the alpha hydrogen atoms, under basic conditions, it can undergo a self-condensation type of aldol reaction, right? So I want to add here that I will not be going to discuss the mechanism of aldol reaction here. I have already done so. I have already done that in my previous lecture. So once again, I request you, if you want to go through the mechanism of the aldol type of reaction, you can check out my previous videos, right? So this is the aldol type of reaction here, which will be going in between this molecule with another molecule, another same molecule, right? So it will be leading to the formation of this kind of beta hydroxy aldehyde, right? This is the aldol product here, right? So I'm just explaining here on this slide that how we will be getting the major product, that is this alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde. Okay, so what will happen is that first of all, this will react with this under basic conditions, resulting in the generation of this beta hydroxy aldehyde. After that, there is also a possibility here that this aliphatic aldehyde can react with itself, undergoing an aldol type of reaction, giving a different kind of beta hydroxy aldehyde, right? You will see here that this beta hydroxy aldehyde, I mean this beta hydroxy aldehyde, is actually different from that of this beta hydroxy aldehyde, right? This is the product of cross aldol reaction. On the other hand, this is the product of an aldol type of reaction, and both the reactions are going on simultaneously in this Claisen-Schmidt reaction, right? Now the question is that how we will be getting this alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde in the end of this reaction, right? For that, let me go to the next slide, and we will see here that first of all, out of this and this product here, this will be the major product, and there is a valid reason that why this will be formed in major amount, right? On the other hand, the aldol type of product here, I mean this product here, will be formed in the minor amount, right? Now what will happen next is that under the basic conditions, a molecule of water will be going out from this beta hydroxy aldehyde, and we can call it as a dehydration type of step, okay? Now what will happen is that the OH will be going out from here, and the hydrogen will be moving out from here, giving a double bond at this position, I mean this position here, right? So that we will be having the alpha beta unsaturated kind of aldehyde. This is the aldehyde here, and this is the alpha position, this is the beta position here. So in the end, we will be having this alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde molecule, and because it is being generated from the major intermediate here, this is the reason why this will be formed in the major amount, right? And let me tell you that why this is being formed in the major amount here as compared to this beta hydroxy aldehyde. The reason is quite simple, because this, upon elimination of a molecule of water, is giving some product here that is having an extended type of conjugation, right? So let us see where is that extended conjugation. You will see here that this is the double bond here in this final product molecule, followed by a single bond, once again a double bond, then a single, and in the last one more double bond, okay? So it is this extended conjugation which is making this product molecule extremely thermodynamically stable, right? So this is the major product here of this first Claisen-Schmidt reaction. Overall, I will say here that when we will be adding this thing to this thing under basic reaction conditions, First of all, it will be generating this beta hydroxyaldehyde, and then this beta hydroxyaldehyde, this will be formed in the major amount, this will be formed in the minor amount. After that, this will further undergo reaction in this way here, and this reaction will be nothing but the loss of a molecule of water, giving this alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde as the major product. As far as the second intermediate is concerned, that is this beta hydroxyaldehyde, which was formed in the minor amount, it will not be giving further reaction, because here in this case, the loss of a molecule of water will not be giving much thermodynamic stability in the form of extended conjugation. Okay. So this means what? That if we will be removing a molecule of water from here, I mean OH from here, one hydrogen from here, this will be giving a double bond here, but that is relatively less thermodynamically stable as compared to this product here that is having a lot of conjugation. I mean the alternate double and single bonds, right? So this means what? That the final outcome of this Claisen-Schmidt reaction, in which some aromatic aldehyde is reacting with some aliphatic aldehyde, is this here. I mean, two products we will be getting. The major product will be this one, and the minor product will be this one here, right? So with this, the first reaction of the aromatic aldehyde and aliphatic aldehyde is over, and you have seen that two products will be formed. One will be major and the second one will be a minor product, right? And now it is time to have a look on the second reaction, which was in between the aromatic aldehyde and some aliphatic ketone molecule, right? So this was the reaction. The conditions are basic here, because it is a standard for a Claisen-Schmidt type of reaction. And you will see here that the product is what? Starting from this carbonyl, this is the alpha position once again. This is the beta position here. And because we are having some unsaturation in between the alpha and the beta position, so it is nothing, it is some alpha beta unsaturated ketone molecule. Okay, so why we are not calling it as alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde this time? Because you can see here that this is what? This is a ketone type of functional group here, right? So on the alpha and beta, we are having unsaturation, and ultimately it is a ketone molecule, right? So if we want to see that how the reaction of this and this is giving this alpha beta unsaturated ketone molecule, we can go on a similar type of pathway, right? So first of all, this will be undergoing a cross aldol type of reaction with this aliphatic ketone molecule, right? Why we are calling it as a cross aldol type of reaction? Because it is quite simple. This reaction here is occurring in between one aldehyde and one ketone molecule, right? So obviously it is a cross aldol type of reaction. The result will be what here? It will be, if this is the carbonyl here, this is the alpha position, and this one here is the beta position. You will see that on the beta position, we are having a hydroxyl group, and this is the keto part here. So this is nothing. This is a beta hydroxy ketone, right? So this is the first step. This upon reaction with this will be giving a beta hydroxy type of ketone molecule. Okay. But at the same time, because this aliphatic ketone molecule contains the alpha hydrogens, the conditions are basic once again. So there is a full possibility that this aliphatic ketone molecule, it can undergo reaction with itself, right? So that will be a type of an aldol reaction, because same molecules are reacting with each other. That is an aldol type of reaction, isn't it? So this ketone molecule will be undergoing a self-condensation. That is an aldol type of reaction. Once again, this will be giving, if this is alpha, this is the beta here. Once again, this will be giving a beta hydroxy ketone molecule. But definitely, this beta hydroxy ketone is different from that of this one here, right? So it is now time to see that how we will eventually be getting this alpha beta unsaturated ketone, right? So once again, this beta hydroxy ketone molecule will be undergoing a dehydration type of reaction here. I mean the loss of a molecule of water. So the OH will be going out from here, one hydrogen from here, and in this way it will be giving rise to a double bond in between this carbon atom and this carbon atom here, right? So we can say even in this case that it is having an extended type of conjugation, which you can see here. This is the double bond here, then alternate single bond, once again a double bond followed by single, and in the last one more double bond here, right? So this extensively conjugated product here is thermodynamically stable, and this is the reason why it will be formed in major amount, right? And after that, once again this beta hydroxy ketone will not be giving any further reaction, because after the loss of a molecule of water from this beta hydroxy ketone, we will not be having any stable type of product molecule. The reaction will simply stop here at this stage in this side reaction, right? So ultimately, from this second reaction that is taking place in between the aromatic aldehyde and aliphatic ketone, we will be having two different product molecules. The first and the major one will be this alpha beta unsaturated ketone, and the second, the minor product, will be this beta hydroxy ketone molecule, right? So this is just an overview for the Claisen-Schmidt type of reaction. We have seen two different reactions, and in both the reactions, the first reactant molecule, which is an aromatic aldehyde, that is not having any alpha hydrogens. The second reactant molecule, which is an aliphatic aldehyde containing alpha hydrogens in the first reaction, and an aliphatic ketone once again containing alpha hydrogens in the second reaction, they will be going reaction under basic conditions, giving rise to alpha beta unsaturated aldehydes or the ketone molecules, right? So in nutshell, the Claisen-Schmidt reaction, I mean this thing here, is nothing. It is actually a special case, right? A special case of what? A special case of cross-aldol type of reaction, which is base catalyzed. And the reactants are of what type? Aromatic aldehyde, which are not having any alpha hydrogens, plus some aliphatic aldehyde containing alpha hydrogens, giving alpha beta unsaturated aldehydes, okay? And we can also have the reaction of aromatic aldehyde with some aliphatic ketone. This is the same thing which I have just told you, right? So once again, under the basic type of reaction conditions, giving alpha beta unsaturated ketone molecules, right? So it is now time to talk about the mechanism part of this Claisen-Schmidt reaction. So you can see here, I am discussing the mechanism from the first reaction's point of view. Okay, so I am taking the aromatic aldehyde, that is benzaldehyde here, and from the first reaction I am taking the aliphatic aldehyde, which is acetaldehyde. Okay, what I mean to say is that out of those two reactions, I am taking or I am considering the first reaction in order to discuss the mechanism part, right? So the mechanism for the second reaction will exactly be similar, right? So here is the base here, because the conditions are basic, you can see, right? So first of all, what will happen is, in this mechanism, the alpha protons have a special property, and it is what it is. These alpha protons are acidic in nature, right? So acetaldehyde molecule here is having the alpha hydrogens. This is the first one, this is the second one, and this is the third one. And all three alpha hydrogens are acidic in nature. So if we will be adding some base here, definitely the proton abstraction will be the first step, right? And you can see here, this base is abstracting a proton from this acetaldehyde molecule, generating what? Generating a negative charge here on this carbon atom. And this OH negative, upon abstracting a proton, will be generating what? A molecule of water, right? So now after that, this negative charge here on this carbon atom, it will be acting as a nucleophile. We know that the carbonions are good nucleophiles, and moreover, if you look here on the first reactant molecule, which is benzaldehyde, this carbon atom here is having a partial positive charge. This means this carbon atom having partial positive charge is actually acting as the electrophilic site in this reaction mechanism, right? So here is the nucleophile, here is the electrophile. What will happen is that the nucleophile will be attacking on the electrophile, right? The reason behind the electrophilic nature of the carbon atom here is that it is bonded to some electronegative oxygen atom. Okay, so this is having partial negative and this one here is having a partial positive charge. Okay, so after proton abstraction, the next step is what? It is the attack of the nucleophile on this electrophilic carbon. And because of that, what will happen is these electrons will be shifting to the oxygen in this way. These pi electrons will be shifting onto the oxygen. And due to this, it will be resulting in the formation of a new bond in between this carbon atom and this one here. Okay, which you can see on your screen. I am talking about this new bond formation here, right? After that, the next thing is what? That the molecule of water here, it will be acting as an acid, because we know that water molecules are amphoteric in nature. They can act as an acid as well as a base. Right now in this mechanism, the water molecule is acting as an acid here, so it will be giving a proton molecule, right? So when this will be giving a proton, it will be taken up by this oxygen negative, you can see here in this way, so that this O negative will now become what? It will become a hydroxyl group here, right? So followed by the next step, which goes something like this. The conditions are basic, so hydroxide ions are still there in the reaction. The next thing which will happen in this mechanism is that this is the alpha carbon atom as compared to this carbonyl group. It is still having two alpha hydrogens. This is the first one here, this is the second one. And I have just told you that the alpha hydrogens are acidic in nature. So these can be abstracted by a good base, right? So the OH negative is a base here. This is a base here. And the alpha hydrogens, this alpha hydrogen as well as this alpha hydrogen, these are acidic in nature. Let me write here, these are acidic in nature and these can be abstracted by this base, giving what? Giving a carbon having a negative charge, right? So after that, this negative charge will be delocalized in between this carbon and this carbon atom in this way, giving rise to a double bond here. And this OH negative will be going out, which you can see here. It is going out of the system and then it will be used as a base for the next reactant molecule, right? So finally giving us this major product, which is the alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde molecule. This is the aldehyde part here, right? So this is the major product of this reaction. And we have just seen that how the mechanism or the reaction is proceeding, resulting in the generation of this kind of major product, right? So after that, here are both the reactions, and I have just discussed about the mechanism of the first reaction, I mean this reaction here, right? So we have just seen that how this major product will be formed. And as far as the minor product is concerned, obviously, let me write here, that will be formed because of the aldol type of reaction. That will be formed because of the aldol type of reaction, okay? And let us not discuss here the mechanism of the aldol reaction, because that is a separate reaction, right? So I have already discussed that in some of my previous lectures. So two products, this is the major, this is the minor. The minor product will be formed by the aldol type of reaction and the major product by the mechanism which I have just discussed, right? And as far as this, the second reaction, I mean the second Claisen-Schmidt reaction is concerned, it is following a similar type of mechanism. You can always check it out and you can always try by yourself. And I'm quite sure here that you will be following the same mechanism, ultimately you will be leading to this alpha beta unsaturated ketone molecule, right? So this is it about the Claisen-Schmidt reaction. थैंक यू सो मच।